stuck there. You see, what you are doing, and this is exactly the same thing for canter pirouettes. Not that you're there yet. What you're doing is making it smaller as you go.
Okay.
I'd like you to think about starting small and making it a little bigger. So, half full, now step a little forward. Step a little forward. There, there, there. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Now, he's still getting a little funky lateral as he's figuring it out. But let's go ahead and try. And sitting trot. Good. Yeah. I forgot the headsets, which are in my suitcase.
Oh, I can grab them.
You want to bring the suitcase?
Yeah, absolutely.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Please, go ahead.
Jeez, where's
her? And just make a large circle.
Can you ride him? Can you ride him? I'm not in a panic because he's deep, but he's also opening his mouth and pulling his tongue out a little bit. Yeah. Easy hand. Again, if he stays a little deep, that's okay. I just don't want you making it deep. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Is he okay in his mouth for double?
Yeah. I started it. He's had a little bit of that tendency to pull his tongue up.
Yeah. Try to keep contact with his mouth. Your hands are bouncing a little forward and back.
Good.
And on the long side, fall somewhere in your arm. Doesn't matter where. Good. And trot. Now. Better than I thought. Okay. Yeah. And straight ahead, and then center line again. And shoulder and left. Very good. I'll get out of the way. And track right. And walk the trot. Trot. Yeah. Good. And circle here. And walk here. Now, the first mistake was fine. Second mistake, shouldn't happen. We ride too well. Challenge yourself to communicate a little better. And straight. And hump in. And straight. And haunches in again. Pretty good, much like haunches in on so. Little tiny bit up there. And now a couple strides of a little haunch. Not any faster. Not any faster. Yeah. Good. Good. And straight on the circle. And now haunch out on the circle. Bend to the left. Haunch to the left. Haunch to the other. A little bit more. There. Yeah. Good. And straight. Bend, which means bending a little right. And then haunches out and in. A little away from the wall. Yep. Good. 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 And now straight on the circle. Good. Now, I would like to see a happle that creates as much as the walk to trot creates. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
I think of the walk to trot as like a three-quarter. Mega, mega happle. And you've got to be able to do that before you're going to get a good happle. But can you get just a little more? Gary shifts his weight back just a little more. Okay, good. Good. And again. Yeah. And try it again. Yeah. Now you be very careful that you and your body don't tighten up as you do it. Yeah, you're gonna use rage. But make sure you don't get tight in using your urge. Hard in using your urge. And again. Mega. Now. Do that little short and touch it with a whip. Don't chase him out quite so much. There. And then direct what you just collected up. What you are doing is you are shortening him and then chasing him out. Make sense?
Yeah.
So you wanna coil the spring up a little bit and then direct it uphill rather than just letting it shoot forward. Good, good. My legs are a little better. And straight ahead. And again, your feet walk back. Six or eight steps. And drop. Good.
Whoa.
Yeah.
And hold. Now, you have a way of getting it tighter. You don't pull, you just get tighter.
Okay.
You know, and I think especially when you're trying to use your back a little bit, and then your contact. Sit, just keep your hands still, don't push. Then you end up doing this a little bit.
Okay.
If you're trying to go that much, I'll tell you, you drop it. Now just stay with me. Just stay with me. Let me move on.
Yeah.
So you need to go like that.
That's what I like to hear.
When you're trying to be like, you just.
Yeah.
Instead of just being tall and thin. That's what keeps it coming. Let me get this one more.
You don't want that.
It's that teeny little hole that keeps it on. It is totally alive. Now, pull out the hole.
And we're just going to trot again. And I just want you to take a minute. I don't quite know how to put it in words. But is what I'm saying to you, can you relate to that? You lose that little bit of connection. And I'm not in any way saying you should be pulling on it. I'm saying you should be able to be very soft and there. Instead of soft. It's actually not soft, it just gets loose.
Yeah, and you drop it.
Yeah. So when you're ready, go to trot. Push him just a little bit. Up. Just make sure the muscle tone of your arms stay elastic. Is this making sense?
Yeah, it feels already a little better.
Yeah.
I just need a lot of practice.
Yeah, you just need to think about it for a bit. And walk to trot, staying with him. Good. Good. Okay, and let's walk. Now, basically, I'm going to leave that thought with you. I may remind you every now and then. Good. And straight onto the wall. And another turn on the haunches. Half halt. Step forward. Step towards his nose. Half halt. Yes! He still finds that a little weird. His legs, he says, my legs don't quite go like that. And now let's go straight ahead and canter. Oh, that shouldn't have happened. It's easy for me to say. Good. Now, at S, let's go on like a 20-meter circle. And on the circle, a little haunches in, not too big, not too big. 20-meter circle. This arena is a lot wider than 20 meters. Yeah. Haunches in and straight. Active. Not too big. Haunches in. Good. And straighten and collect to walk. Good. And shoulders in front of him. And canter. Don't overbend the neck. Active. Come on. Make that first step count. And collect to walk again. And canter. Yup. Yup. And haunches in again. Good. Good. And straight ahead. And we're going to stay on half the arena. You're going to go down to about B and E. And canter to walk. Straight ahead, canter. Ooh. You're allowed one of those.
Okay. Better shape up.
And after R, canter to walk. And walk. And canter. And turn. Good. And walk. Sorry, I'm a little late there. And canter. And walk. Straight, canter. Straight, straight. No, no, no. You come right up here to these ear poles.
Okay.
Yeah. And walk. Straight, canter. And turn. Yeah. And walk. Canter. And turn. Turn sort of as sharp as you can. And walk, 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 canter. And walk, straight, canter, straight. I'd like to see a little bit tighter turn. Walk, 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 don't wait for me. Canter, straight, straight. Yeah. And walk. Canter, straight, turn. Yeah, good girl. Forward a little, now walk. Canter. Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, excellent.
And walk. Canter. Straight, straight, straight. And turn. So I'm looking for kind of a quarter of a pirouette, kind of. Sort of walk, yeah, good. Yeah, you make him wait. A little bit forward. And now collect and walk. Good. And turn. Yeah. Good. Good. And forward a little. Normal collected canter. And once more, you're going to make a nice quarter pirouette here. Straight, straight. Oh, you're whipped. Make those people nervous.
Okay.
Walk. Sorry, a little late. Canter. Yeah. See if you can do your turn in two steps.
Okay.
There. That was better. Forward. Forward. Yeah. Sorry. Yeah, don't, you've got enough space that you can have two or three normal canter strides in between.
Okay.
Come on. I'm getting tired, Mom. Check the arms. Check the arms. Yeah. One more. Turn. Okay, straight ahead, normal canter. Now, I'd like you to change direction any way you want, and if you feel like you could do a flying change, do it. But if you don't feel very confident, change another way. In other words, I'm putting all the pressure on your shoulder. Uh-huh. Good. Now, a little bit more active. And a medium canter. Medium canter. Love it. And collect and walk. Good girl. Let's give him a little break. Now, my little rude comments about that shouldn't have happened. Okay? I expect you're a professional. You ride a lot. You're an extremely good rider. And I challenge you not to let these mistakes happen. To be a little more mentally on top of it. You know your horse. You know, first one happened when you were walking and he jaked before you moved on. Things like that. Yeah, mistakes are made, but every time you make a mistake, you have to, instead of going, oh, I made a mistake, I'll fix it. Why did I, how come I let that happen? What was I not paying attention to? He's a very obedient horse. You're a good rider. He seems to have a very good work ethic. Or he's on his best behavior today or something.
No, this is every day.
Okay, let's go medium walk. And then another turn on the haunches. Yep. Step a little forward. Yeah. Good. That one was good, and it's the walk stayed pure. Yep. Good. And let's go to trot. Walk to trot one step. Eyes gotta come back, prompter. Look at how prompt your canter to walk is. And walk. Yeah. It should be a little bit of an effort to come to walk. But he sits. And once again, walk. And now we're going to stay on this end again, using kind of half the ring. And now just shorten the trot a little bit. A little bit of short step. Just a little short trot. Short trot. Short trot. Shorter trot. Forward. And forward. Good. And after the corner again. And again. Staying elastic. Try to come back a little prompter. Yep. Good, good, good. And forward. Good. Yeah. When you bring him back, I would bring your legs back a little tiny bit for what will become a piaf aid when the time comes. But leg back means don't walk. Yeah, good. Yeah, and trot. Now, see if you can do the same thing a little more promptly. Quicker back, few steps right forward. And whoa. tenfold. And this time, once, you'll just give him a little tap with a whip. Short trot, little whip, and forward. Yep, forward. Just the thoughts of it. Good, and forward. Okay, and straight ahead. Good. And center line at A. Directly to a half pass. Oh my goodness, you shouldn't have done that. Right, Emma? You know what I'm complaining about?
Yeah.
That we ride too well for that to happen. Thank you. Forehand. Forehand a little right. Good. Now, let's get your best trot. I'll make one circle here. One walk to trot. Right back. Trot. Up. Good, good. Elastic connection. Straight ahead. Medium trot. Just 4 or 5 steps, freshen it up. And collect. Now, center on half pass. And I want you to pay attention to your riding. Do you keep the same elasticity that you have now as you're going sideways? You actually lost the muscle a little left. Let him come forward, look up ahead over his ears. Good. And walk, drop. That could have had a little warning happen. Elastic. Are you connected? Are your arms the way you are holding his neck is? And his back? Are they all kind of nice, squishy unit together? Center line half pass again. Go straight first. Go straight. And sideways. Good.
She's the one who needs it.
Yeah. Yeah, to her, she said it in my email.
You tend to ride your half pass without your inside leg. Okay. Kind of
good.
Stuck out there.
Okay, gosh for out.
And push for hot me. Direct your inside brain. Okay.
good. Okay, love you.
Okay,
jump,
jump. So you're using your half-sided right, you're using your right brain, or you're using the left?
Yeah.
And instead of using this leg. So I want to take just a minute in the walk to play with this. And my challenge to you is, in your half pass, that you have a little bit of a leading inside brain.
Okay.
In other words, the opposite of what you're doing. Mm-hmm. And what we're going to do is a little bit of switching between, for example, half pass right and leg heel left,
okay.
Which will make you use that inside leg. So you'll be half passing right, and basically what I'm going to be looking for the minute you start to go to an incorrect brain, I'm going to say no leg heel left. That is outside leg working, create then more with your inside leg, and make sure you're not blocking the right shoulder. That's what this will end up being.
Yep.
You're using an indirect brain instead of encouraging in the half pass this way, you're going to be squashing a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So, let's go medium walk.
It's almost cool in here.
I know, but Sabrina keeps it cool really well.
Okay. Can somebody do that for you just for a minute?
Yeah, absolutely. Would you mind just doing it for one sec?
We're going to try using headsets. My headsets are ancient, and they're no longer being made, so I can't, I have to replace everything, which will cost a fortune. Just get her. Put that on her. Don't mount yet. Yeah.
Okay.
So let's go ahead. Just go down the center line. A little shoulder in. Right brain stays right. And half pass right. Leg heel left. Right brain stays right. Take your time. And half pass. Right leg is a third. And leg yield again. Make sure you're sitting level, easy hands. And a couple of half pass steps. And leg yield again. Then you'll make a U-turn. And do the same thing. Kinda hard, huh? Yeah. Keep that right brain away from the neck.